grace to the sky.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio. Crippling diagnosis, ineffective treatments, relentless chronic pain. Many have lost their will to live as their quality of life has deteriorated. Joy and laughter have been replaced by groans of pain and suffering, leaving them feeling trapped after exhausting all options. However, it is in these moments of despair that the power of faith can shine through, offering a new path to healing and hope. It's time to reclaim your health and conquer every challenge. Every Tuesday, we shall have the Mantle of Miracles services featuring the Corridor of Miracles with 12 disciples. These 12 servants of God will form a corridor and proclaim your healing by faith as you walk through. Join us in the Cathedral of Miracles every Tuesday only at 7:30 p.m. at 232 Seven Sisters Road, Finsbury Park, London, N4 3NX. Invite everyone in need of healing, including yourself, and declare your healing and restoration through faith in God's Word.
A very good morning to everyone and welcome to the Be Inspired program. And be happy. If you are not happy, you're going to be, because there is no way for someone not to be happy if God is in their lives. Maybe you woke up today feeling down, feeling oppressed, feeling in a different way. Maybe things are not going the way you were expecting for. But you have to be strong. Victory is not for the weak one. Victory is for the strong one. You know that in this world, in the world where we live in nowadays, we are having a lot of problems, and problems appearing day and day by day. More problems will come. The pressure upon people now, it's great. And you have to be strong. And the only way for you to be strong is when you put your faith into action. Maybe now you are preparing yourself to go to work, you are having your breakfast. Maybe you are now brushing your teeth, preparing everything, getting ready to go out. And how is the way you are going out? You are going out demotivated. You are going out discouraged. You are going out maybe feeling down. How can you face the day, friends? How can you face the day like this? You can't face the day in this way. But I have a word for you. In the very beginning, normally we don't do that in the beginning of the program, but I have a word for you that will inspire you for your day. And there is no better way for us to start our day if it's not with the Word of God. Look what says in Joel. Joel chapter 3, verse 10. It says, "Beat your plowshares into swords, and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong." Look what the word of God says. Let the weak say, I am strong. Now, wherever you are at home, you are preparing yourself to go out, to face the day. You are sitting down in your sofa right now. Say, wherever you are, say now, I am strong. Stop saying, I am weak. Stop saying, I will not be able to. Stop saying, I am down. I am discouraged. I have no I have no clue. I have no strength to do that. Stop confessing defeat. Say, I am strong. And when you leave, when the program is done, you leave your house, you're going to see a great difference in your day, for sure. And I would like to talk to you about something we are having in the church today. As you saw the advert talking about Tuesday. Tuesday is a day for people to do a chain of prayer in order to overcome something in their health, either in their health or in the health of those who live with them, their family members. Today is the day for you to use your faith. We have a corridor with pastors here at 7:30 p.m., in special at 7:30 p.m. We still have services running the whole day. We have service now at 10 o'clock still, 3 p.m., at 10 a.m., 3 p.m., and 7:30 p.m. You can use your faith. Maybe you are watching us now. You are always struggling with sicknesses, diseases. Today is the day for you to come and use your faith. Place your faith into action. Don't stay home crying, murmuring, complaining about the pain, the sicknesses, diseases you have been going through. Use your faith. Wherever you are, you may come to our Cathedral of Miracle here in Finsbury Park, or you can go to your local UCKG. But the most important is use your faith. We are going to go now for a testimony, a very powerful testimony. And when we come back, I'll be talking about something we are going to have in this weekend. Actually, this weekend is going to be a blessed weekend. And I would like you to do something now. As we are preparing ourselves for Sunday, the 29th, to bring back all those who one day were with us here serving God, and now for some reason they are feeling weak, they have no strength to come back. If you are inviting people already, get a piece of paper now. Get a piece of paper, write down the name of the person that you are going to invite or the person you have invited already. And then after the testimony, I'll tell you what we are going to do with that, okay? Let's go for this testimony and we are going to be back right after.
Faith is like my companion, my best friend in this journey for God. That was one of the biggest things that I needed to do with God, which was trust in Him. With that trust, my faith started coming along. Today my life is a blessing. It is great because today I'm a happier person now. I'm more at peace with myself. Now I see that I am being fulfilled. I am being used by God every single day in everything that I do. I work, I'm succeeding at work. I've got job opportunities that are coming up at work. And my manager is actually coming at me to tell me, listen, we have this opportunity for you. We want to get you one of this. It's perfect, it's great, not just at work, but also at home with the people around me. What I give to them, I'm now able to give them something. It has been 2 years since I've been in the presence of God. I can see truly that first, it was my relationship with my family. That was the first thing, because I used to be a big complainer and I didn't realize. And then when I started to walk with God, He started to show me, like, listen, Inej, you complain too much about these things. But when you have this presence, you're able to, you know, be able to have a good relationship with those around you. I'm able to communicate more with my dad because I had held a grudge against my dad from a young age, but when I started to walk in the presence of God, I understood that forgiving was the main thing that I needed to do. And today I have the vision. God has given me the vision. He showed me where I need to be. He showed me what I need to do. Being able to learn how to use my faith was one of the greatest things, because obviously coming through the services, it's been able to show me how I can use my faith. There's nothing impossible with God. Anything is possible. So with that, I use my faith. So at work, when I want to conquer something as well, I go ahead, I use my faith. And because I know that I'm using my faith, of course, I know I'm not going to see it in the next day, but I have the assurance inside of me that it is going to happen because I know that it is His word which stands, and I know I will do it and I will achieve it and I will overcome. My life before was meaningless. Since a young age, I saw, you know, my dad being quite abusive towards my mom, and that kind of painted a picture for me how men were gonna be. So growing up, I said to myself, I'm not gonna allow any men to treat me like this, how my dad treated my mom. So what I did as growing up, I went into a relationship, and in that relationship, I was already like an independent woman. I was determined. So I was very kind of like strong-headed. No, I'm not gonna allow you to do this to me. I'm the one that's in charge. I'm the one that's going to lead. But obviously going down the road, that never worked out. Inside of me, I was very bitter. I would see things and I'll be like, oh, who does this person think this is? And all that bitterness came all the way from the root of starting at home, the issues going on at home, my dad taking us away from my mama's kids as well, and also troubles as well in school, like friendships. I was always like the odd one out because my parents didn't allow me to, you know, go outside, go with the friends. They were like, no, you have to stay at home. And I was always like, why do I have to stay at home? So in that also grew like a little, you know, a little anger because my friends are able to do this. Every time Monday comes, everyone's able to speak about what they did on the weekend. But my weekend was like, no, I had to stay home because my parents told me to stay home. So I had that also accomplishment in the sense of, I need to do this when I grow up. No one can tell me, so I'm gonna go ahead and do it. I would see men as they can't love a woman because in my family, I always see like my uncles having women, talking about women like it was nothing. And then I will see my aunties, even my mom as well, being hurt by that. Women are just here, just a product for men to be used. That's how I literally saw men. But because I had that gap inside of me, because growing up, my dad had left eventually, I didn't have the love of a father. So what I wanted to do, I wanted to have the love of that from a man outside, even though I had the picture of, no, men can't love women, but I know I still needed that, I still wanted the attention. And because of that, that led me to also having panic attacks. The panic attacks started happening when I was studying in Spain. I was by myself and I thought to myself, okay, my boyfriend at the time, he's not here, he's somewhere else. I don't have control, so I don't know what he's doing. In that moment, it's like, no, something's gonna happen. So because of that, I had panic attacks. That's when I realized and I said to myself, okay, there's something wrong with me. So I actually had to like, reflect on myself at that moment. I'll never forget this day when I had the panic attack. And it was something that I shut myself. I didn't even speak to my family about it. I knew they were attending church. The first thing that they would tell me is, you know, you need to come back to God. And I knew I needed to come back to God, but I wanted to have control over my life because even the way I had the perspective of, oh no, God is this way, I didn't even want to approach because I saw God in a way of, you know, if I give my life to God, my life with God will be boring. So that's what I had as well, that picture of God. My situation was at this point where I didn't know what to do with myself anymore. I was empty, I was broken. My family, who actually goes to the church, they invited me to one of the services. My mom, she said, come to one of the services. And I actually went to one of the services along with her. At this moment, I had to make a decision, either continue living in a broken life or in the presence of God. So that's when I started coming back. I started to attend the services. I started to pay attention to the word and actually add it. So as I would hear it, I would go home and I would actually apply it in my life. The Universal Church for me is a spiritual mother because when I came back, it was like, the arms of God was wide open for me. For I'll be judged, I was accepted with open arms. I came back and it was like, I'm home. I could literally feel my soul was at peace. I was able to put my head in my pillow and go to sleep properly. And to be universal is to help others, is to serve others. And because this is what God has shown through Universal Church, God has shown now, as I receive the help, as I receive the peace, I'm also gonna give that peace also to other people. So now I help in the VYG, got soup banks as well. Those who are broken, who come and said, I need help, I'm there, ready to help them, ready to take them out, literally to grab their hand and said, come, I know a place for you. The Universal Church is what you need. And truly, it is what they need. If you are with God, nothing's impossible. So now I am happy, I am at peace, I am full of the Holy Spirit because God has given me that. He sealed me. He said, no, I am with you. And since that day, I never stopped. I never stopped and I'll never stop. I'm gonna go until the end.
Well, you know that we are going to have on this coming Sunday, the 29th of September, something special in the church. There will be rejoicing in heaven, for sure, because there will be many lost sheep coming back, not to the building of the church or coming back to an institution, no, but coming back to the kingdom of God. And I have no doubts many souls will be saved, but God needs to count on us. Maybe, let me talk to you that you are watching us now, and you watch Liberty Radio, but you don't come anymore. You have no strength to come anymore. Sometimes you miss the services in the church, the words you use it to receive, to uplift you. This coming Sunday, God is calling you back. This coming Sunday is the Sunday that you can start over in your faith, and you may come to the house of God, and God, the assistants, the pastors, all of us, we are going to be with our arms open, wide open, to receive you in the house of God. But the fact that I told you for you to prepare at home, you that you are a member of the church, you are an evangelist in the church, assistant, soul winners in the church, and you are inviting already someone, you have been talking to someone, I asked you for you to prepare a paper to write down the name of those people, because we are going to pray based on this Bible verse that is written in Job. Job chapter 1, verse 5. It says like this. It's talking about Job. He would rise early in the morning and offer burnt offerings according to the number of them all. For Job said, it may be that my sons have sinned and cursed God in their hearts. Thus Job did regularly. You see how powerful it is. Job used to wake up in the morning, earlier in the morning, and present offerings and pray for his friends. He used to intercede on their behalf. If he was presenting offering on behalf of his friends, he was praying regularly for his friends, is to keep his friends uplifted, their faith, to uplift their faith. And this is what you should do. From today until Sunday, you still have plenty of time for you to go after someone that is weak. Pastor, but I am saved. I am saved. I am strong. Okay, but this is not all. What God wants is for us to be strong, but for us to help those who are weak in their faith. Go after someone. Get the letter that we have been giving during the week. Get that letter. Help us to make that letter to reach someone that is weak in their faith, and they will come back on this coming Sunday, and for sure, they will start over with Jesus, and they will remain until the end, in the name of Jesus. And this paper, keep with you, because today, during the prayer, you are going to hold it into your hands, and we are going to pray for them. Pray for God to give them strength. Pray for God to give them power. And this Sunday, they will come, and they will be blessed. We're going to do exactly what Job did in the past. We're going to pray on behalf of our friends in faith. Amen? And whilst you prepare the paper, you prepare everything for the prayer, I would like to tell you about something we are going to have on the 30th of this month. It's going to be on the coming Monday. We are going to have in the church the entry of the ark. It's going to be in special here in Finsbury Park, where the pastors, They will conduct the ark throughout the corridor of our Cathedral of Miracles here in Finsbury Park, moving towards the altar. The ark will be put on the altar. It's going to be a blessing for everyone. The Bible talks about Obed-Edom, where the ark was in his house for a couple of months, because there was no place to put the ark in that time. And he offered his house to keep the ark in there. And the Bible says that during this month, or this couple of months that the ark stayed in his house was a blessing. There was healing. There was prosperity in that house. There was blessing in that house. You see how blessed it is. How blessed it is. And the ark represents the presence of God. It's not the ark itself, but the Bible says that the presence of God was in the ark. And it made all the difference. All of you, you are invited to be with us on this coming Monday at 7:30 p.m. to see the entry of the ark and to bless your life. You can even write down in a paper your prayer requests to bring and cry out with us. And in the same way, Obed-Edom, he was blessed. His house was blessed. For sure, your life is going to be blessed in the same way. Amen? Let us prepare ourselves to pray now. Prepare your bottle of oil for us to anoint ourselves. Prepare the paper with the name of your guests you are going to invite for this coming Sunday, because now is the moment of prayer.
Let's talk to God. It's time to pray.
My Lord and Father, here we are in this faith to anoint ourselves every single day. And in the same way I do here, I know that people at home, at work, they are doing the same, anointing themselves with the blessed oil. And the oil represents the Holy Spirit. My God, give your people strength for them to go throughout the day strong in their faith. Today, they have so many things to deal with. They have problems to solve. They have situations they need to deal with. They have a lot of things they need to do during the day. And I believe, my Father, that your Spirit is going to help them. They are not alone at all. You are with them, my God. If there is anyone who was thinking to give up on everything, they don't know what to do with their lives anymore, please go there, my Father. Let your presence go wherever they are, and your Spirit is going to give them the power, the strength they need to face all those problems. My God, I ask you now, this person is holding in their hands now the name of their guests for the 29th. And they are doing exactly the same job. The same what Job did in the past, they are doing right now. They are praying on behalf of them. And I believe that this coming Sunday, there will be rejoicing in heaven, because many people who are lost, many lost sheep will come back to the house of God. And I believe, my Father, I believe that there will be a start over for this person in their faith. many souls will be saved. I surrender their whole day into your hands. My day, our day into your hands. This day is going to be a productive day, if it makes sense. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. I have no doubts you are blessed right now. You are strong, ready to face the day. But before we finish the program, we couldn't finish the program with the thoughts of the day. Let's go now for the thoughts of the day.
And now, the thought of the day.
You know, the thought of the day for today is, never confess defeat because your words have power. Wow, this is so powerful. Never confess defeat. Negative words can imply in your work, in your life, in everything. Make a pact with yourself to not say negative words anymore, to not confess what is negative. Confess what is positive. Pastor, but what about if everything is going wrong, if everything is not going well, it's not going the way I was expecting for, still confess victory. Confess what is good, and it's gonna happen in your life, okay? It was my pleasure to be with you today in this morning, having, not physically, but having this breakfast with you in the morning. And tomorrow, we are going to be here back again to pass on to you faith, a word of faith to bless your day. God bless you all and see you tomorrow.